I follow my dreams. You'd think they were nightmares the way they scream. I make them believe.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we have this beauty of a book. So this is Turn of Iron by Cassandra Clare, the Last Hours book 2. So this is the Ferroloot custom edition to their one, of their first one. So this is literally all in silver front. We have the spine, and then we have also have the back. It says, secrets consume even the truest love. And there's the rune. Well, I think it looks like a moth with a skull in the middle. You can't at the moment, you can kind of see. You can see these moths kind of in the back. But we do have my little thing in the back. So I'm going to go through these tabs anyway, because basically this book is more about James and Cordelina and some other characters, which was definitely a book I did not expect to go through the book about. Something very different about this book, everything like that, but we're going to go through these little annotations so it's more easier and I don't explore as much, because I know most of you guys have probably read this book by now and know what it's about, but I'm trying to do these spoiler free. So the first page that I'm going to is actually these pages, where these pages are just have these pictures in it. Ouch. So this is of Cordelina Carstair. So it starts off with her and James basically getting ready to get married. And, well, not married to each other, they're going to get married, but it's more of fake marriage, because they wanted to, she saved James's life and James thought he needed to represent that to get together, and decided to want to, like, make sure he's ready. And basically he married her because he thought he owed her life, his life to him, to her. So on the page 79, sorry, I'm putting these page tabs down as I go down. It says, 33 years ago, I married Will and Tessa Heronold in this very chapel. How proud and grateful I am to come here to marry their son, James, to a woman whose family is also close to my heart, Cordelina Carstair. And that was such amazing. I love that. And so onto the next page. It's actually going to show you a picture of James. I just love these artwork. These are so cool. So, like I said, James on his mat, the night before the wedding, the supposed wedding, he basically gets an image of the hell of the creature that they just defeated, and they thought that he was dead. James said that he won't be revived until another 100 years, but it seems to be sooner than ever. So now we've got him able to see kind of the future lights. Then next is another picture, and that's of Matthew Fairchild. So Matthew is like a friend to James, basically, and like his backup line to the person. And he is quite intriguing. Let's see what he's about on there. Let's just say that. Okay, so the next one we have a picture of Lucy Heronold. You know, I'm saying these names wrong probably, but look at that. That's so pretty. So as throughout the book as well, we have the story that's going on between James and Cordelina. I hope I'm saying her name right, I'll probably not. And then we have these two little chapters. We've got the 1800s, about Grace, with Grace and her brother, which we'll get through when the characters come along. And then we have also about the London kind of chapter, where the murderer of Shadowhunters come in close to as well. And it seems that this person is going around killing Shadowhunters to be stronger to go against Cordelina and James. Which was like, oh my gosh, what have I just seen now? Okay, so on the page of, so in the 1800s, something about Grace and all that. So this page, it says, Cordelina, you are a great heroine, even in the realm of the dead, they speak of you. You are the bearer of the blade Cortana, which is, you can slay anything. You have spilled the blood of Prince Hell. You have saved me. The Prince of Hell is the one that's basically awake and slowly coming into us. And as you slowly, you can see it slowly coming together back to the moths. Which is cool. Give me the next page. If I can get to it. Okay, so this one, I'm not going to say much about it. I just really like the artwork, so I'm going to show you. This is between Anna Lightwood and Adrina Bridgestock. So this is something about what happened in the past. But that is a beautiful... These artworks are just amazing. Okay, so I want... After I read a book, I always go to myself, oh, I would love to see that on a bookmark or a blanket or something. And on page 244, it was, let conversation stop, let laughter cease. Here's a place for the dead delight to teach the living. I was like, that sounds amazing. I would love to have that on a blanket or bookmark or some kind of something that I can sit my butt on. Her cushion would be funny. Anyway. Yeah. Okay, so then another little quote on him was, he's a prince of hell. Who knows what he can do? I cannot live my life wondering, nor can I let myself be free if I am that some kind of threat. I need to know and I must know. So throughout the book as well, we find out that the Prince of Hell has, I can't say his name, Berlin, seems to have gone inside James and kind of controlling him, we think. And they're trying to sort that out, trying to get away from him because, oh, there's some stuff along here. Okay, so the next bit is a picture of Jesse Blackthorne. So Jesse here is, the guy that actually is Grace's brother, but poor Jesse here actually died. He died as soon as he was placed the first rune on him. He died on the night, but he's still a ghost. So Grace can still see him in the kind of evening times when he comes up as a ghost and they kind of help him in trying to like pretty much get through it. But they're trying to get him, like his mother's trying to get him back to, like, bring him back to life. And, because when Jesse, well, basically, Grace didn't know they were pretty much, apparently she didn't know that she was shadow hunters because they said not to touch anything. And now she's a shadow hunter pretty much because she wants to find out what the heck is going on and why he didn't survive it. Then the next character, we have Thomas Lightwood. I just like these artworks, so I might not say anything about them, but they're good. Then we have the guy they talk about a lot, is Alistair Carstyle. He's one of the, like, it's like he's one of the older men inside it, but pretty good. Then we have Christopher Lightwood, who is the kind of scientist guy. As you can see, he's got, like, some potions. But going through this book, I was like, oh my god, there's so much going through this book that I just can't, I don't want to keep talking about it because I'm like, oh my god. And then we have Gracie Thorpe Blackthorne. So it seems as through the book, and that's all the little, as you can see the moth bell. So Grace through the book seems that she put a bracelet on James to make her fall in love with her. And I don't know what's going on. So the way it ended, you know there's going to be a book three. Because it literally just ends with... If I can find it. He held it tightly, silently, and the carriage pulled away from the Waterloo and rumbled into the light. Into the night. That's literally how it ended. And I was like, what? Then we have the apology of basically... Titania Blackthorne being with the Berlin guy, the evil guy. So I feel like the third book is going to be about them. And we also have a little chapter which is about Magnus and Jem. It says, one must always be careful of books, a bonus story featuring Magnus and Jem. So it's just about them going through a little system. But the way this goes through is going to be interesting and I'm looking forward to see how maybe that third book is going to be. Because at the moment they've done gold, iron, like silver colour. Wonder if they do a third book, then I'm happy. But this book was definitely, I love anything that's Shadow Hunters, anything that's literally that I would love, I would have it. I cannot wait to see merch for the last hour books. I'm so intrigued. Like, well, should I say more of the Chain of Iron, because we've had some of the stuff from Chain of Gold. But there we go. Chain of Iron, guys. So next up, we should have, well, I'm going to say The Whole New World by Liz Branswell, because my bearing car is Dawn, it's not here yet. Here yet. Well, time this video comes out, it might be here. So, yeah. There we go, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.